Joshua Phillips was born on March 17, 1984, in Allentown, Pennsylvania. His father, Steve, was an alcoholic and drug addict who frequently tormented him and his mother. Steve's temper was so bad that he once put his fist through a wall, making sure everyone in the household was terrified of him. Philip shared his father with his two older half-brothers, Daniel and Benji. Despite their 11-year age gap, Josh and his brothers did everything together. From sharing music and watching movies to attending concerts, they were inseparable. That would soon change. In 1997, the now 14-year-old Josh moved to the Lakewood suburbs of Jacksonville, Florida, with only his father and mother. His brothers would stay behind to live with their mother in Pennsylvania, despite numerous pleas to their father to not move away. The quiet community was an idyllic change for his parents, who were both computer specialists. Joshua, however, felt very out of place and found few friends at his new school, the A. Philip Randolph Academies of Technology. Josh was lonely and became a C-average student who spent much of his spare time watching porn at home. However, he did befriend his 8-year-old neighbor, Maddie Clifton. Maddie was born on June 17, 1990, and Lakewood was the only neighborhood she had ever known. Her neighbors were always lovely, and her parents, Steve and Sheila Clifton, let her wander around playing as young kids do. Maddie and Josh had played together on numerous occasions. They were very friendly and always seemed to enjoy each other's company. In the early afternoon of November 3, 1998, Joshua Phillips was in his front yard playing baseball. Maddie crossed the street and asked to join him. He agreed to let her play. After one unfortunate swing, the ball rocketed off his bat and hit Maddie in the eye. Naturally, she began crying from the pain. Josh was terrified of the consequences from his father, so he dragged Maddie into the house. Desperate to silence her before his father got home, Josh strangled and hit her with his bat, but didn't kill her. He hid her unconscious body under his bed. When she regained consciousness later that day, she started to moan and make noise. Phillips again tried to silence her, but it would be for good this time. Josh lifted off his mattress, took out his multi-purpose tool, slit her throat, and stabbed her 7 times in the chest. He then placed his mattress back on the bed frame. Maddie's mother reported her missing at 5 p.m. that same day. Lakewood residents and police searched everywhere for Maddie, but nobody could find her. Josh even joined in the search on that very first night.
We were raising our girls in a Christian home where we prayed every day. What we didn't know was that the devil himself had moved in right across the street. The same devil that picked up his flashlight and proceeded to look for her, knowing good and well where she was the whole time.
He would later say of this decision,
"Through the entire time, I was putting myself in a fantasy world that nothing had happened. And that was my defense for everything when I was a kid, was if something went wrong, ignore it, it'll go away."
To be thorough, police searched Josh's home 3 times. Each time, they mistook the stench of Clifton's body for the smell of birds that Joshua kept in his room. Without any leads, the FBI was called in to join the investigation. At the same time, the search party was now in the hundreds. Volunteers searched the forests and swamps and handed out flyers offering a $100,000 reward. Any hopes the residents had left would soon be extinguished. In the early morning of Tuesday, November 10th, Joshua's mom noticed an unusual wet spot on her son's bedroom floor. She also saw that part of his bed frame was broken and taped together. When she took a closer look under the bed, she saw Maddie's lifeless body and frantically ran out to speak to the police. She told reporters later, quote, "I just pointed to where they needed to look. I couldn't even go back in," end quote. Police cordoned off the crime scene and arrested Josh while he was at school. Joshua Phillips confessed and was charged with first-degree murder. His trial began on July 6, 1999, and he was tried as an adult. Prosecutors argue that the murder was sexually motivated because Maddie wasn't wearing all her clothes when the police found her. Phillips' lawyer, Richard Nichols, argued that her clothing came off when Phillips dragged her into his room. He went on to say that her death was, quote, an act that began as an accident and deteriorated through panic that bordered on madness, end quote. Clifton's body ultimately showed no signs of sexual assault. The defense didn't call a single witness during the two-day trial. It ended with jurors deliberating for little more than 2 hours before finding Phillips guilty of first-degree murder. The now 15-year-old was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. He didn't say a single word throughout his trial. Joshua spent the first few years of his sentence getting his high school diploma and taking college courses through the mail. He tutored other inmates, helped them with their appeals, and attended religious services. In June of 2017, Phillips was allowed to undergo sentencing one more thanks to a Supreme Court decision in 2012 deciding that it was unconstitutional to sentence a juvenile without the chance of parole. Before the resentencing hearing, Phillips said,
a lot of people say, do you think you deserve to get out? I said, I don't know. My same answer as I always said before was, I really don't know if I deserve it or not, you know, but I know I want it. I want to get out. I want a second chance. And I know that I know that I would live by it, you know. I know I would do good. When I think about it now, I had this kind of like a little apology, like anything I go through, to make certain that she knows that, that I'm sorry, you know, and that, and also that that I'm trying to make her life worth something. You know what I mean? I'm trying because I'm still here. So I'm trying to make certain that I can be somebody. You know, not because I need to be somebody, but because I can be someone who can help people. You know, I don't want to be just about Josh. You know, I want to be someone who can relieve suffering.
In 2023, he will be eligible for another resentencing trial, exactly 25 years after the murder occurred.
Should he ever be released from prison, I pray that I will no longer be on this earth.
It eroded our marriage, replaced love with grief, deep sadness, and a pain that no family should ever have to bear.
After the funeral, I don't really know if I can tell you what happened until I graduated high school, because I don't remember. I don't remember anything.
Let me know your thoughts in the comments below.